Amigos, have you ever wondered how those cinematic VFX shots are made in sports features? Today, I'm pulling back the curtains on those iconic HBO True Detective inspired visuals that I created for the CJ Stroud feature that aired on Amazon Prime's Thursday Night Football. I'm breaking down two standout moments that made the feature unforgettable. And if you're into sports VFX, you won't want to miss this video, so stick around. And if you're serious about leveling up your sports VFX game, check out my masterclass and get on the waitlist. Details in the description. And remember, life is truly a gift. Make it count. Amigos, let's dive into how I brought this VFX sequence to life. First up was keying out the green screen. My usual workflow kicked in. I began by applying Lumetri color and using a LUT to balance the colors. From there, I used selective color to really punch up the green, then hit it with key light for the actual keying. After that, advanced spill suppressor took care of any green spill hanging around, and I wrapped it up with a refined hard mat to clean up those pesky edges. Next, I tackled the football helmet. I used After Effects built-in 3D camera tracker to track the movement. Once I had the track, I hopped over to Photoshop and used its AI generative fill to expand the image of the high school football stadium. It needed a little extra real estate. Back in After Effects, I combined that extended image with a photo of the football field to create a basic 3D setup for the background and floor. With everything in place, I scaled and positioned the football field until it locked in perfectly inside the 3D helmet comp. From there, it was time to get precise. I jumped into Mocha AE to track and roto the inside of the helmet. The goal? Use that mask to reveal only the 3D track of the football field inside the helmet. The result was totally worth it. Now for the fun part, creating an edge map. This step was all about isolating the edges of the player. I started with a chroma key comp, added a white fill, and threw on a fast blur at around 35 pixels. Then I layered it over a black solid to create a high contrast black and white image. Back in my master comp, I used this edge map as an inverted luma map. And to fill in the gaps, I added another copy of the chroma key comp underneath and gave it a black fill. Finally, amigos, I pulled everything together. I layered the 3D helmet track over the chroma key and edge map comps, added a texture, and cranked up the contrast. To give it that cinematic vibe, I added some stock footage of clouds, gave it contrast, and tinted it black and white. The result, a nearly monochrome composition with all the color coming from the football field inside the helmet. And for the finishing touches, I sprinkled in some film grain and used a camera lens blur effect tied to a custom blur map I made with a gradient ramp. It added just the right amount of depth and polish. Okay, amigos, let's break down the shot of CJ and his dad. I worked on a few similar shots for this project, but the technique stayed pretty consistent. For this one, I used a slightly tweaked version of my go-to chroma key workflow. I started by applying Lumetri color and a LUT to balance things out. This time, however, I skipped selective color and jumped straight into key light and advanced spill suppressor. For CJ's dad, I added refined hard matte to clean up the edges and give it that polished look. Now for CJ, I had to go the extra mile with two chroma keying techniques. When it comes to preserving details in hair, key cleaner is my go-to. It just works better. So I set up two different chroma keys, one for his hair using key cleaner and another for his body using refined hard matte. To make this happen, I created masks. one for the hair and one for the rest of his body. And honestly, it was pretty straightforward. A handful of keyframes and boom, it was done. And a pro tip, always double check the alpha channel to make sure everything is looking perfect. For the edge map, I applied the same technique to both CJ and his dad as I showed in the earlier example. Simple, but super effective. Now let's talk about the flower shot. I used rotor brush to isolate the petals and gave them a white tint. For the background, I added a Gaussian blur to enhance the depth of field and then threw on a purple tint. Why purple? It ties into forgiveness, which is such an important theme in this story. And to bring it all together, I use a copy of the chroma key comps as an alpha mat to composite the tinted flower shot on CJ and his dad. Then for those final touches, I added some film grain and a camera lens blur linked to a custom blur map I made with a gradient ramp tool. And just like that, amigos, the shot was complete. Amigos, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this VFX breakdown. And if you want to level up your sports VFX and graphics game, check out my masterclass. The details are in the description.